Legacy is about a group of friends who have been waiting to go to the party of the year. You know, they've saved up, they're waiting to go, and they get kicked out before they even step foot in the door. So they decide to throw their own party, throw the most epic party to kind of compete with and be better than that party. And it's just about how they kind of overcome all the obstacles, and yeah, it's just a feel-good, fun movie.
Tell us a bit about your character specifically and working with the rest of the cast. Mm-hmm.
So I play Sean, and Sean is, you know, he's this cool, charismatic guy, natural-born leader, and he kind of, and his friends, as I said, decide to throw this epic party.
Obviously, it's a lot of fun on screen. What's your fondest memory from set?
The whole thing was a blast to film. Just kind of hanging out and you know, getting to know all the guys. It was a lot of fun.
Legends of Tomorrow. What does it mean for you to be a part of that DC universe?
Oh, it's amazing. I mean, I'm a massive comic book fan. Always have been. So just to be a part of that whole world and the universe that Greg Berlanti's created, I'm very blessed.
Obviously, I mean, Arrow and Flash have been a huge success. What do you think Legends of Tomorrow is going to kind of bring to that TV universe? How do you think it's going to compare to those shows?
I think it's going to do really well. I mean, like, we're bringing together a team, you know, all these personalities, all of these heroes all working together. I think it's going to be great.
I think fans were especially excited that your character isn't one that they're already familiar with. Does that make it easier or does it bring a bit more pressure?
Well, it's interesting. It's interesting. I can't say too much about my character, but I think fans will be happy when they find out exactly what the deal is.
Of course, you're working with a great cast on that one. Who are you most excited about working with, and have you had a chance to meet anyone else yet?
Yep, I've met all pretty much all the guys, and like, to be honest, like, they're all so cool. I just can't wait to start and be involved in the whole production. The whole superhero genre, it kind of, it's that whole good versus evil thing, and I think that's like a battle that everyone sort of fights in themselves, that whole what's right and what's wrong, and I just feel everyone can kind of relate in some way to that genre.
And of course, there's been a bit of a debate, particularly with the Marvel Cinema Universe, about a lack of diversity, as it's being perceived, you know, a lack of female heroes, a lack of ethnic minority heroes. Do you feel that shows like Legends of Tomorrow are a good way of kind of offsetting that balance and kind of addressing that concern?
Oh, definitely, definitely. I feel that especially nowadays, they're really diversifying. I mean, in regards to Marvel, I mean, you've got the new Fantastic Four, and you've got Michael B. Jordan as Johnny Storm, which is dope. So yeah, definitely. And there's a lot more female superheroes that, I mean, on CBS you've got Supergirl. I think it's a good time for diversity at the moment.
Are you excited about the prospect of potentially getting to wear a costume? Because I think everyone, you know, wants to be that superhero. Everyone wants to put on the costume.
Well, as I said, we'll see how, I haven't actually read any of the scripts for the show yet. So we'll see how it pans out.
Does that make you nervous though, being part of something we haven't even read a script yet?
A little bit, but you know, I trust fully in Greg Berlanti and those guys and Andrew Kreisberg and all the guys involved, and I know that they're going to bring something dope. So
I think obviously fans have loved the fact that Arrow and Flash have been integrating, they've been having crossover episodes. Are you a fan of those shows, and are you excited about the prospect of maybe getting to guest star occasionally?
Most definitely, most definitely. If I could cross over into those shows, I'll be over the moon.
If you could only do one, which one would you go for?
Oh, I can't. That's a hard one. That's a hard one. I'm not sure.
Curious, when you were a kid, did you have a favourite superhero?
I did. I have two, actually. I have a DC favourite and a Marvel favourite. So my DC favourite is Batman and Marvel is Wolverine.
Who would win in a fight between those two?
I'm not sure. I want to... I don't know. That's a close one. I feel it could go either way. Maybe if it was just straight up, like they just meet in an alley and just go at it, Wolverine's taking it. But with prep time, I think it would be hard for anyone to beat Batman if he prepares.
There's been a lot of debate about whether or not the DC TV shows might one day get their own big screen outing. Is that something that you'd like to see? Do you think that the shows could make that leap onto the big screen?
I mean, I definitely think that that's a possibility. I mean, if that happens, that'll be awesome.
You got a message for fans, I guess particularly DC fans, who are really excited to see you joining that world?
Just that I can't wait to be a part of it, and I hope you all enjoy it.
What are you hoping fans take away from Legacy when they get a chance to join the party?
Just to experience one of the best parties ever.